Hi, today we're going to melt some granite. First, what we're going to do is we're going to light a methane-oxygen flame. Methane is the same gas that you would cook with at home if you have a gas stove. There you can see the flame. We're going to adjust it. However, when you burn methane or natural gas at home in your stove, you burn it in air. Here we're going to burn it in pure oxygen. That gives us a little bit of a hotter flame. Then, once the flame becomes properly adjusted, we're going to hold a piece of granite. Let's see if we can see the granite at this point. Here it is. It's a granite rectangle, and being held essentially in a pair of needle nose pliers. And this granite, which is actually a type called granite diorite, will be placed in the flame and will start to heat up. So we're adding heat to the granite, which will increase its temperature. The flame is becoming very bright at this point, and we should be able to reach a temperature close to 1500 degrees C by holding this piece of granite in the flame. 1500 degrees C is the equivalent of about 2700 degrees Fahrenheit. At these temperatures, the granite should melt completely. In fact, some of the individual minerals, such as magnetite, that may be present in small amounts in the granite, will probably melt nearly completely at this temperature. Also, some of the minerals in the granite have water contained in their crystalline structures. That water will form small bubbles in the molten rock. When we're finally done melting a little bit of this granite, the granite piece will be covered with what is essentially volcanic glass. And the glass could have small bubbles in it, which would then be representative of steam, the steam being produced by the destruction of what we call the hydrous minerals, or the minerals that contain water in their structure. One of the reasons that we're interested in molten rock in this laboratory is that molten rock, of course, exists in nature. Now, it's not heated by a flame inside the Earth. Rather, the Earth, even now, is generating heat by way of natural radioactivity. And in places, the crust of the Earth can melt. There are many complicated processes involved in the formation of a granite magma that I'm glossing over at this point. And magmas can transport ore metals up toward the surface of the Earth. Not to the surface, but near the surface, the magma may pool in what we call a subvolcanic conduit and release those ore metals into steam that's forming bubbles within the magma. That steam leaves the magma, can flow into fractured rock, and form veins of ore minerals and other minerals, essentially forming a mineral deposit. And that mineral deposit might be economic. And if it's economic, given the economic conditions and the technologies that exist at any time, we might call it an ore deposit. And an ore is something that can be mined at a profit. So right now, we are heating the sample up. It's probably developing something of a glass, of a molten rind on it. Now, at some point soon, we will remove the sample from the flame. There you can see it glowing white hot still, developing a little bit of a red edge as it cools, now glowing orange, still emitting some radiation of its own, electromagnetic radiation or light, because it's hot. Now it's probably just radiating in the infrared, and we can't see energy being emitted from the sample. And now the sample is just cooling because it's now in air, and the air is probably convecting around that sample, carrying heat away, and thereby causing the temperature to drop. So here we see the result of the melting experiment. This is a small piece of the granite which has melted. You can see this glassy area on top of the specimen, which is just a few millimeters across. That is, for all intents and purposes, volcanic glass that we created by melting the granite in the torch flame. There are, if you look closely, some small spherical structures that you can see within the glass, one toward the upper center part of the glassy area. And that circular structure is in fact spherical, and it is a bubble. It's a bubble of steam, and the steam was released from some of the water-bearing minerals that were in the granite. And so here, as you can see, we created volcanic glass in the laboratory.